I spent thousands of dollars on network switches. Not all at once, worse. One at a time. Each one got me a little closer to what I actually needed, but also a little more frustrated that I didn't get the right one the first time. And that brings me to a phrase I've ignored for years. Buy once, cry once. It's one of those sayings that sounds obvious. Spend more upfront and avoid buying the same thing three times. But in practice, it's not that easy, especially when you're on a budget or you think you know what you need. Do I buy the $150 DeWalt impact drill even though I drill into concrete about once every 10 years? Or is the Harbor Freight one good enough? Same with the boom arm on my microphone. That spring squeal drove me nuts, and I finally got the PSA-1 and never heard it again. Plastic measuring cups with numbers that fade off after 6 months? Or stainless steel ones that will outlive your kitchen? Tried using RGB hue bulbs for video lighting, constant flicker. Switched to an Amaran 150C and never saw those lines again, and now I actually trust my lighting to look good on camera every time. We all have these decisions, but when it comes to tech, it gets even more complicated. Because tech moves fast. There's not just cheap and premium anymore. There's good, better, best, and bestest. And a lot of us, especially in the home lab crowd, convince ourselves that buying incrementally is smarter. Just what I need right now is what I typically say, but all of those small upgrades, they add up. So how do you know when to stop climbing the ladder? For me, it was switches. Over the years, I kept upgrading, trying to solve just one more problem. That got me a 24-port Cisco switch, a Dream Machine Pro, it's technically a gateway, but I used it as a switch, a Pro 24 PoE switch, the Switch Pro 48-port switch, and a Flex 10 gigabit switch, and the Switch Aggregation Pro. All of them replaced now with a single switch. But let me explain. My first real switch was a 24-port Cisco. Solid, but no PoE. And that was fine until I got access points and cameras. So I got the Unify Pro 24 PoE, 16 PoE plus ports and 8 PoE plus plus ports, and a few SFP plus ports. And it looked like I had some headroom. But then came more access points, more cameras, more devices, more Ethernet runs, and suddenly I needed more ports. So I got the 48-port Pro PoE switch. That held me over until I needed more 10 gig ports. So I picked up the Flex 10 gigabit Ethernet switch, thinking I solved the problem. Except for it only has 4 10 gigabit ports, and in my setup, one of them was used for the 10 gig uplink, so really I paid $300 for 3 usable ports. Then came more servers, so I bought the Switch Aggregation Pro, and at this point I had multiple switches stacked in my rack, and every time I made a change, I had to think about where things lived. More cabling, more power draw, more heat, more noise, and even though Unify makes config easy, performance and troubleshooting becomes more annoying when 10 gig devices aren't on the same switch. The real tipping point came when newer devices started showing up with built-in 10 gigabit Ethernet ports that use standard RJ45 connections. Not SFP+, not optional add-ins, just 10 gig over copper out of the box. So now, I need to buy SFP Plus to RJ45 transceivers to plug them into my existing switches. That means more adapters, more expense, more heat, more complexity, all just to connect devices that were clearly built with 10 gig base T in mind and not SFP Plus. It's not that SFP Plus is outdated, but more and more consumer and prosumer gear are moving to 10 gig by default, and I find myself constantly adapting instead of just plugging devices in. So, I finally bought the switch I probably should have started with. No more stacking switches, no more juggling uplinks, just one box that does the job. It has 48 multi-speed ports. The first 16 support 10, 100, 1 gig, and 2.5 gig, and the next 32 support 5 and 10 gig on top of the lower speeds. That's a huge upgrade. I used to need a whole separate switch to handle 10 gig devices like the Switch Aggregation Pro, and now I can plug everything directly in one place without juggling port types or reworking half of my setup every time I need to make a change. All of them are PoE++++. Yeah, that's 90 watts per port. That's wild. You could literally power a laptop over Ethernet. I wouldn't try it though. In my case, I'm powering a Flex 2.5 PoE with it, a cool little device that uses PoE++++ and provides PoE++ to downstream ports. It's kind of like PoE Inception. The switch itself powers everything else too, access points, cameras, and whatever else I plug into it. And this one switch now replaces both my 48-port PoE and my Switch Aggregation Pro. The price? $2,742.76 shipped to my door. Yeah, I cried. But then I added up the cost of all the other switches I bought in the past to get here, and I cried again. And here's the thing. None of those switches felt like a bad decision at the time. Each one felt reasonable, logical even. I just need a few more PoE ports. I only need 2 10-gig links. I don't want to overbuild for no reason. Now, I've spent more hours than I care to admit moving patch cables, redoing VLAN assignments, wondering which switch port was causing a bottleneck, all because I didn't want to overcommit. But the irony is, I ended up committing more. More money, more hours, more frustration. And that's where I think the buy once, cry once really hit me. It's not about maxing out your credit card on day one. It's about finally recognizing that solving the same problem over and over again is the expensive path. If I had just bought the Switch earlier, I would have saved money, I would have saved time, and I would have saved rack space, and probably a couple Saturday afternoons I spent tracing cables and jumping between interfaces on 3 separate devices, time I could have spent doing literally anything else. Still, this time, I'm done. At least until Ubiquiti releases the 48-port Ultra Pro Max HD ++++ AI Quantum Switch, which, let's be honest, they probably will. To be fair to myself, this switch didn't even exist a year ago. But if I'm being honest with myself, I probably wouldn't have bought it then anyways, because I didn't have the buy once mentality. I was still thinking short term, still trying to spend just enough to get by, but not enough to get done. And just to be clear, I'm not telling you to go out and buy the most expensive thing you can find. Heck, I'm not even telling you to go out and buy a Ubiquiti switch. I'm just sharing what I learned the hard way. That chasing short-term solutions can sometimes be the longest path to getting to what you actually need. And this video really isn't about a switch or even about technology, it's more about the decision-making process. About taking a step back from the pile of parts and asking, what's actually going to solve the problem? Not just today, but long-term. And that brings me back to the question I keep thinking about. Is buy once, cry once just future-proofing? Or is it something else? A mindset? A moment where you stop chasing upgrades and just let your tools do the job. Maybe it's about value. Maybe it's about peace of mind. Maybe it's the relief that comes from finally not needing to fix what should have been right from the beginning. I'm still not totally sure. And if this helps you avoid just one round of trial and error, then hey, maybe all those switches I bought weren't a total waste. So what about you? Is there something you bought over and over again trying to save money, only to regret it later? Or something you finally splurged on and never looked back? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your buy once, cry once stories. And hey, if this video got you thinking differently about how you approach gear, maybe stick around and subscribe. I'm Tim. Thanks for watching.